So you have to know the graphs of your basic functions. A linear function is in the form of f of x equals mx plus b. You might remember y equals mx plus b, m is the slope, and b is the y-intercept. But right now we're just kind of looking at the graphs. This is a horizontal graph. This has a slope of 0. So that would be gone. So that's what we were talking about, like y equals 2. We've graphed those some today. This diagonal line, that's y equals mx plus b. That has some sort of slope, like a slope of 2, for example, maybe a y-intercept of 3. But that's what linear functions look like. A polynomial function, polynomial means many terms. And we've just got this one term here, x to the n. This looks like a quadratic here. So this is a special one, x squared. It's in the shape of a parabola. And because it has a 2 there, we call that a quadratic. And this one, you've got x cubed. And so it kind of has that n behavior where you start down and go up. That's a polynomial function, or we call it a cubic function because it's degree 3 here. It's hard to see. F of x equals x cubed is what's written. I've mentioned this one. I called that a radical function. That's a radical function where y equals the square root of x. So if you don't see a number here, it's understood to be a 2. So that's what radical functions that have a square root in it look like. If you have an odd index like this, it's also called a radical function, but what happens is it becomes something like that. So it has a kind of the similar shape here, but it also gets reflected or rotated, and it's also going this way. So that's what radical or root functions look like. A rational function. Rational has the word ratio in it. That means fraction. So a rational function is a function that has a variable in the denominator. And what there's a lot of math going on here that I'm skipping over, but the reason that these rational functions look this way is because you can't have 0 in the bottom of a fraction. So when you're talking about domain, x cannot be 0. And so it creates this asymptote, this line that isn't really part of the graph, and it's going to create these branches that are going to get really, really close to x equals 0 but never be able to touch it. So rational functions have these asymptotes in it, these branches. You have to pick up your pencil to graph them. So here's another one. Y, this is hard to see, but it's f of x equals 1 over x squared. See, x can't be 0, so there's this asymptote through here. So if you see two branches that are disconnected and seem to be trying to get really close to a specific vertical line, that's a rational function. Exponential functions, they look like J's or backwards J's, like that. And an exponential function has a number to a variable power. So like this is a decaying function. This would be like y equals 1/2 to the x power. And this is increasing, so maybe something is doubling every day. And be like y equals 2 to the x. You just need to know the shapes. You don't need to know the functions, but just FYI. So backwards J's or J's are exponential functions. Branches are rational functions. Sideways half U's are square root functions. And this is a cube root function. This is a polynomial or quadratic function. That's a polynomial function or a cubic function. And then the last one we've talked about a lot, absolute value functions. That's what absolute value looks like, and that's a V. All right, so that's part one. If you want to practice in the lab manual, you can go to page 4 and read what we were supposed to learn. Try to your hand at the definitions here, and then you have a lot of practice at function notation. So look back at your notes and try these. A lab manual is the best place to go to practice, even much better than WebAssign. And I have the keys posted, so try all of these. And then there's a couple of questions here. You can go to Desmos and put these in, which I'll show you next time.